Season greetings to everyone, and a Merry Christmas to each person and each family member. We would like to invite you to join me in prayer as we begin this special program. Let us pray. O God, our Heavenly Father, we thank you for bringing us to another Christmas day. We thank you for the blessings of the year between the last Christmas day and this one. And as we launch into this special broadcast, we ask that your Holy Spirit will hover over each viewer. May we sense your presence, and may our minds be directed to that day when you enter the human race as the Savior of all mankind. Bless us. Refresh us now, we pray, as we place this program in your hand, for Christ's sake. Amen.
Good morning, Guyana, and Merry Christmas to all of you. I know most of you are probably busy opening your gifts or now about to sample your pepper pot with your bread or cassava bread, but we're not here to disturb you from any of that, but rather we are here to add to your blessings on this blessed day. We're here with a young Adventist group. It's a combination of four young people from four different Adventist churches across Central Georgetown, and they're going to be bringing harmonious singing to your ears today. And before we go further, let's just hear a bit about them. Tell us your name and which church you're from.
Hi everyone, I'm Edwin Moore, known as Jerry, presently at the Ephesus Seminary Adventist Church.
Hi everyone, my name is Rita Amsterdam. I'm from the Central SDA Church.
Hi everyone, my name is Altia Melville from the Olivet SDA Church.
Hello, my name is Oliver Smith. Everyone knows me as OJ, and I'm from Grove SDA Church.
All right, so who's the group leader? Who's going to tell us a bit about the group? OJ?
Well, yes, I'm going to say it. Okay, our names, we're known as Adoration, and we would have been together for about 4 years, and primarily in singing ministry. We sing at church programs, concerts, and so on. We'll do a little backup from time to time, and we just enjoy what we do, and that's mostly it about us.
All right, I'll let you demonstrate later in the program. Yes. But we know this is a season of giving and sharing, but most importantly, this is the season where we celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ. So Adoration is going to bring to you the gospel in the form of music. So I hope you guys enjoy. Sit back, relax, enjoy a pepper pot as they bless your hearts.
Oh, come my faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him. Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
Joy to the world, the Lord is come. Let earth receive our King. Let every heart prepare him room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and heaven nature sing. He rules the world with truth and grace. praise and makes the nations prove the glories of his righteousness and wonders of his love and wonders of his love and wonders and wonders of his love.
Okay, this next song is one of my favorite songs for Christmas. It's called Silent Night. It reminds me of, you know, a calm, Christmassy, you know, groovy feeling, you know. I just like the song and it gives me a sense of what, you know, Christmas is all about. So I hope you enjoy it.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round young virgin, mother and child. So tender and mild, sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace.
A Merry Christmas to everyone, to each of you. I trust that you are having a peaceful, lovely, joyful time with your families. Today we'd like to share from the Word of God a few nuggets to focus our minds on this festive season concerning the meaning and the message of Christmas. Before we proceed further, I invite you to join me in a word of prayer as we ask God's blessing on this presentation. Let us pray. Loving Heavenly Father, we ask that your Holy Spirit will hover over each person now and enter each home as we focus on your word today. In Jesus' name, amen. Charles Dickens in 1968 said, quote, "I have always thought of Christmas time when it comes around as a good time, a kind, forgiving, charitable time. The only time I know of in the long calendar of the year when men and women seem by one consent to open their shut up hearts freely and to think of people below them as if they really were fellow passengers to the grave, and not another race of creatures bound on other journeys," end of quote. But where did Christmas come from? The precise origin of assigning December 25th as the birth date of Jesus is unclear. As a matter of fact, the New Testament provides no clues in this regard. December 25th was first identified as the date of the birth of Christ by one Sixtus Julius Africanus, in 221 AD, and later it became the universally accepted date. One widespread explanation for this, for the origin of December 25th as the date of Christ's birth, was the Christianizing of the Dies Solis Invicti Nati, meaning the day of the birth of the unconquered son, which was a popular holiday in the Roman Empire that celebrated the winter solstice as a symbol of the resurgence of the sun, the casting away of winter, and the heralding of the rebirth of spring and the summer. And so Christmas began to be widely celebrated with a specific liturgy in the 9th century, but it did not really attain to the liturgical importance of either Good Friday or Easter, which are the two other major Christian holidays. Notwithstanding, ladies and gentlemen, the message of Christmas is universal and should be embraced by all. Christmas, firstly, ladies and gentlemen, reminds us that we can have peace when faced with circumstances that can elicit fear. Christmas should remind us that we can have peace when faced with circumstances that elicit fear. The gospel according to Luke reminds us that when the shepherds saw the angel, they were afraid. The Bible records in Luke chapter 2, verse 8 to verse 14, it says, "And there were in the same country shepherds, abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night." Verse 9, "And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid." Not just afraid, but sore afraid. Perhaps they stood there, wide-eyed with wonder, knees knocking and trembling, because of this supernatural being in their presence. But the angel comforted them and said, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people, for unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord." And then the Bible says, "And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, peace, goodwill toward men." Oh, friend of mine, we all need the peace that only Jesus can give. You see, every person's experience testifies to the fruitfulness of the words of Scripture. Isaiah chapter 57, verse 20 and 21 declares, "The wicked are like the troubled sea when it cannot rest." In other words, sin has destroyed our peace. Sin has destroyed our peace. You see, the masterful passions of the heart no human power can control. We are as helpless here as were the disciples to quiet the raging storm. "Ha! But he who spoke peace to the billows of Galilee has spoken the word of peace to every person. However fierce the moral tempest, Christ can give us peace. He who stilled the physical raging storm can still the moral storms in our hearts." So the first message of Christmas is that Jesus came to give us peace, peace of mind and rest of soul. Peace that can result when we are about to close our eyes in death. Peace which can result in an unfurrowed brow and a smile on our face. Peace, the first message of Christmas. The second message of Christmas is that we can have the blessing of God's protection and guidance. We can have, in this world, the blessing of God's protection, the blessings of God's protection and the guidance. You see, God protected the wise men from wicked King Herod and guided their steps away from the net that he planned for their feet. So the Bible records in Matthew chapter 2, verse 7 to verse 14. The Bible records, "Then Herod, when he had privately called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, 'Go and search diligently for the young child. And when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also.'" So the Bible says, "When they had heard the king, they departed, and lo, the star which they saw in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. And they worshipped, and they brought gold and frankincense and myrrh." Then the Bible says in verse 12 of Matthew chapter 2, "And being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way." So God warned them away from Herod's plan. God also protected Joseph and Mary and the child Jesus. Matthew chapter 2 and verse 13 says, "And when they," the wise men, "were departed, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream, saying, 'Arise and take the young child and his mother and flee into Egypt, and be thou there until I bring thee word, for Herod will seek the young child to destroy him.'" And so God can protect us, even as he did the wise men and Joseph and his family. He can protect us from criminals, from people who would want to try to do us harm, perhaps using witchcraft and such like. God can protect us from the anger of evil angels and guide our steps to safety. David testifies in Psalm 91 and verse 1, "He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty." God protects his children. He continues by saying, "I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, in him will I trust." I am glad that we have a God who can protect us as we travel through life. The third message of Christmas is that God reminds us that we can trust his promises. We can take him at his word. The first promise of a coming Savior is found in Genesis chapter 3 and verse 15. "And I will put enmity between thee and the woman, and between thy seed and her seed. It shall bruise thy head, and thou shalt bruise his heel." And the promise tarried, and its fulfillment. But its fulfillment was sure, even though the promise tarried. And then, according to Galatians chapter 4 and verse 5, the Bible says, "But when the fullness of the time was come, God sent forth his son, made of a woman, made under the law, that to redeem them that were under the law, that we might receive the adoption of sons." So when the fullness of the time was come, providence directed the movements of the nations, and the tide of human influence and impulse until the world was ripe for the coming of the deliverer. The nations were united under one government, one language was widely spoken, and from all lands the Jews would come for the yearly feast, and then they would depart to spread the knowledge of Jesus and the tidings of the Messiah to come. And so, friend of mine, God's promises are sure. Perhaps you've been praying for something for a long time. Maybe you have placed something in the hand of God, resting them on a promise. And you're praying and you're waiting, and the answer seemed to be tarrying for a long time. But friend of mine, the message of Christmas is God's word is sure. We can trust his promises. The Bible reminds us in 2 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 20, for all the promises of God in him are yea, and in him, amen, unto the glory of God by us. And so through Christ, all God's promises are dependable. Yes, friend of mine, the message of Christmas is that we can, number one, trust God's promises. Two, we can ask his protection. And three, we can claim and accept him and the peace that he offers. The story is told in 1988. Anissa Ayala was 16 years old and diagnosed with a rare form of leukemia. The doctor said that if she did not receive a bone marrow transplant after chemotherapy and radiation treatment, she would die. Neither of her parents nor brother was a match for her, and they could not find a donor anywhere. And so her parents, both in their 40s, conceived another child and hoped that its bone marrow would be compatible with Anissa's. Ah, to their great delight, it was determined that this new baby was a compatible donor. And when Marissa Ayala was 14 months old, the baby, they took some of her marrow, bone marrow, and gave it to Anissa. Anissa made a full recovery from leukemia, and both sisters lead healthy lives today. Oh, friend of mine, as we close, Jesus was born into this world for the express purpose of saving us. He is the one and only true Savior that can save all those who put their trust in him. And Christmas marks the day we celebrate his birth, and without him, we would not have salvation. So with these words I say, Merry Christmas to you all and your families, and may God's richest blessing attend us all. Let us pray. Loving Father, we thank you for your word today. Bless each person. Be with that man, that woman, that boy, that girl. And may we afresh give our lives to you as the Savior of mankind, who came to see about us, to live and to die for our sins. Thank you that you rose again, and that you're interceding for us, and you will come again to save us all. Thank you for this wonderful day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Guyanese, the holy festival of Christmas celebrates the miraculous birth of Jesus Christ. His birth was a fulfillment of a prophecy foretold centuries earlier in the book of Isaiah in the Holy Bible. Christmas represents the promise of peace, an eternal and universal human aspiration. The Gospel of St. Luke in the Holy Bible reminds us that on the night of Jesus' birth, angels proclaimed, "Glory to God in highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." Christmas recalls that Christ was born into a family. Jesus came into the world as a baby born into a family. He belonged to a model family, the Holy Family. The family is the divine creation which must be protected. Christmas is a time to strengthen the bonds of fraternity, friendship, and familyhood. It is a time for family reunions and for spreading cheer by exchanging gifts, visiting friends, attending church, sending greeting cards, singing carols, and sharing dinners within the home and in the community. Christmas reminds us of our duty to each other, particularly the nurses, soldiers, policemen, and other working people who will spend their Christmas away from their families and homes. We are reminded also of the plight of the poor, the weak, the destitute, and those who are sick, in grief, and in need at this time. We're all part of society. Guyana is in a better place at this time The future is bright. Things will get better in the months, years, and decade ahead. Citizens' quality of life will continue to improve. Everyone, regardless of class, ethnicity, gender, or place of residence, will benefit from the continued growth and development in our country. The Holy Festival of Christmas is an opportunity to strengthen the bonds which unite us as a family, as a community, and as a country. Let us be the agents for promoting peace and bearing goodwill to all. Let us ensure peace, goodwill, and safety in our homes, on the roadways, and in our communities. A happy and peaceful Christmas to all Guyanese.
On behalf of the Board of Directors, management, and staff of the Guyana National Newspapers Limited, we would like to wish our advertisers, our readers, and our viewers a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. The tidings we bring to you and your King. The tidings of Christmas and a Happy New Year. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas, everybody!
Okay, so this next song we're doing is named The First Noel, and we're going to flow into Mary, Did You Know? Did you know?
Did you know?
Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconcile. Joyful all ye nations rise, join the triumph of the skies. With angelic hosts proclaim, Christ is born in Bethlehem. Hark the herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. May your heart be light. From now on, our troubles will be out of sight.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the yield times gay. From now on, your troubles will be miles away.
Here we are, as in olden days, happy golden days of yours.
Faithful friends who are dear to us, gather near to us once more.
Through the years, we all will be together.
Keep the faith alive. And from the shining of a mountain,
a merry little Christmas now. Have yourselves a merry little Christmas now.
That is all we have for you today. I hope you would have enjoyed that, and I trust that your hearts are indeed blessed. Be sure to pick up a copy of our Christmas edition. Our reporters have worked so hard to put together some special features for you. Be sure to get a copy. We're not working today nor tomorrow, so our next edition will be until Saturday, the 28th. If you have missed this show from the beginning, you can go back and watch it on YouTube and on our Facebook page. Both are at Guyana Chronicle. Be sure to check it out. And that is all we have for you. Merry Christmas again from the Board of Directors and the management and staff of the Guyana Chronicle. You guys enjoy the rest of the day.
Far behind. Run, run, Rudolph, Santa's gotta make it to Georgetown. Oh, Santa, make me hurry, tell him he can make you see why I rode down. Oh, run, run, Rudolph, feeling like a merry run. Say, Santa, to a little boy, what would please your most before? jet. She said a little baby doll like a grinder, sleep on wet. We're gonna have